That's right. When we follow the Ten Commandments, it shows we trust God or something greater than ourselves, which effectively means we don't make ourselves an idol.
So
life so far. Or at least inconsistent, where I simply avoid and so break the rule, or should I say, the trust? As in being God would trust. I think the opposite of render is to trust, but should. How many times a day do I use that? I shouldn't be surprised if I should all day long, since I often use its relative might, as in, I should, or I might, but will I? Do I really? That's my point. Lead me not into temptation, especially from tempting myself. For my good intentions that say, I should, I might. Those good intentions don't make me good. And it's also easy to break the rule by simply avoiding, postponing what is clearly God's will. For example, these things call the Ten Commandments, right? I like this version of the kids, for the kids. It's for kids of all ages. I mean, number three, why I always say God's name with love and respect. I should. And I might. But what if I catch myself saying, oh my God? Hear me that? Is that really respectful to throw that around? Love and respect for mom and dad. My dad was here last week, as many of you know. And when my dad calls, might I say, yeah, thanks for calling. Yeah, I'm kind of busy right now, but I'll get back to you later, I promise. Can I really that busy? I mean, my dad's 95. How many more years do I have? Shouldn't I take more time to honor my father? It happens. Always tell the truth. All the truth. All the time. Oh my. Yeah, I should. I might. But what? Oh, is that what we are? Be happy with what I have. Don't wish for other people's things. Yeah, I should. But I admit some of you drive some nicer cars than I do. Why not buy the little thing? Sometimes I want a little more elbow room now. But I haven't quite got enough of this thing. But that's okay. Don't wish, trust. Trust. And I suppose I could go on. Right? We could look at this all day and come up with all sorts of examples. Where we might miss the mark. Or we should have thought we would. We forget or replace God's will with our own. I know I'm guilty. How about you? I suspect we all are. But wait, there's hope. For at the end of this sermon, I can declare that that's why we're here. That's why it's good to come to church, to be reminded and encouraged that God's will isn't hard. God's will is for good. Our good. Oh my gosh. Everybody did this. Just a bit more every day. If everyone did what we know we should, so hard. And the way that you live life starts with our will, our deciding to act, our resolve to follow through.